Here we go.
Once we've scanned you, there's no going back.
What's been going on?
Nothing has been going on! You're getting obsessed.
Once we've scanned you, there's no going back.
Mom, things are changing quickly. We're entering the new age. The new age.
Once we've scanned you, there's no going back.
Well, we don't know what this means, but we can show you an extraordinary photograph of an extraordinary lightning strike at the Christ the Redeemer statue that towers over the city of Rio. More than just an outburst of nature, it apparently caused damage.
From God. Just hours after the Pope announced his surprise resignation, the heavens over Rome opened and the top of St. Peter's Basilica was struck by lightning.
I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven, like lightning from heaven.
This is about the manifestation, the physical body. This is about birthing that Antichrist. And it's to do with the time change, and it's to do with the transfiguration of the planet into the Golden Age, which is the New World Order, Age of Aquarius, and the Age of Saturn, and that is what they want to happen. This is the satanic plan, if you like.
An induction of possession. The communist scientists and psychopoliticians have devised a method of combining music, hypnotism, and Pavlovianism to nerve jam the children of our nation without our leaders, teachers, or parents being aware of its shocking implications. An ideology so ruthlessly materialistic as communism, says Edward Hunter, would be at variance with its own philosophy if it failed to make use of drugs and hypnotism. Drugs and hypnotism. Hypnotism. Drugs and hypnotism. Drugs and hypnotism.
We'll be right back. the very first words of Genesis, the very first words of God, is that in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form and void. There was no form to the earth. If the earth has no form, that means it has no shape. The earth cannot be a spinning ball and yet have no form. Now, when the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters, which side of a spinning ball would be the face? You see, the very first words of God are telling you the earth is flat. He lets you know right away. And when God said, "Let there be light," on the first day, what was the earth revolving around before he said that? There was no sun. You see, that's how you know that the light God created is the same size as the moon, just as it appears, and that these two lights are circling above us on the flat earth model. It doesn't work on the spinning globe model. It only works and makes sense, and it makes more sense if it's a flat plane. The coming great deception, what it boils down to is you either trust the word of God and believe him when he said the earth is flat, or you're calling God a liar and that he's silly, because none of this makes sense, and God is not the author of confusion. None of it makes sense because we've been lied to about the very foundation of what God is telling us about. You can read the Bible all you want. If you don't know and have the context of truth and the Holy Spirit dwelling in you, none of it is going to make sense. All of it's going to blow by your head, and it's going to be pointless. Yet that book is the very word of God. How that book cannot hit you and bring you to goosebumps every time you read it, being the one word of God, that should be telling in itself that God is not dwelling with you and that you're following Satan. Because Jesus tells us that the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth. Meaning, if you don't know truth, you don't have the Holy Spirit with you. You're not following God if you're still believing Satan's lies of living on a globe or whatever else they are. Whatever other lies you follow, God says, "My people perish for a lack of knowledge." You can't just be all hunky-dory and think you're saved and yet not know anything about God, his word, his son, where you live, and not even want to seek it out and learn, and still think that you're going to be accepted into his kingdom when you don't know nothing about him or truth or anything because you follow Satan's lies. You'd rather take the easy way out. You're not here to be average. You're here to fulfill greatness. And greatness only comes from God and being with him. And you ain't going to be with him no matter how much you think you are because you're a good person. You ain't going to be with God if you don't know how to protect yourself from the enemy, from Satan. He tells us we're not to be ignorant of Satan's devices. He then goes on to tell us about the firmament, dividing the waters from the waters. And then in Matthew 4:8, when the devil tempted Jesus and took him up to the highest mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world. You can't do that on a globe. You can't see all the kingdoms of the world from a high mountain if it's a globe. So the coming great deception is already here. All it is do you trust God and follow God, or do you trust man's doctrine?
What the do we do?
Hey, cool, I'm dead.
Please hold on to the handrail. Do not spit over the side. Por favor, aguántese en la baranda. No escupas en los lados.
Great Grandpa Simpson.
Please hold on to the
Snowball.
Handrail.
Snowball.
Do not spit over the side. We told you to hold on to the handrail. We asked you not to spit over the side.
All these people who are buying into this whole new age, third eye, manifestation movement, you know what? You're going to manifest yourself right off a cliff. Because all this stuff is the very same forbidden knowledge that Satan promised Adam and Eve in the garden. And they would get knowledge of good and evil. This is that same forbidden knowledge emerging again, okay? And it's real sad seeing everyone jumping on board to this new age deception. Because what people don't understand is that all the evil and corruption that's being exposed is part of the plan. They have created this for the purpose of exposing it and then appearing to be conquering it is the righteous ones, thereby deceiving the truly righteous into supporting and electing them. You see, Satan is the one who's waking up the world right now. You understand? With this whole new age spiritual movement, the third eye, manifestation, all that stuff, it's all evil. It's all the satanic lie. The same lie the devil promised Adam and Eve in the garden. Because you got to think about it. Do you really think that they would be letting this stuff get out and letting the world wake up and learn all this stuff of like third eye being able to manifest anything? Do you really think they're going to let us learn that power if it hasn't already been tainted and twisted into serving them? I mean, you got to think about it. To be able to manifest, the world ain't just waking up like this and they ain't just allowing it. It's all part of the plan. This whole spiritual new age movement, the meditation, the yoga, it's all Satan's final card he's playing on the world, man.
Howdy, stranger.
I'm Bart Simpson. Who the hell are you?
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm the devil. And you've earned eternal damnation for your lifetime of evil deeds, Bart.
You know what? You're going to manifest yourself right down into hell. As you people are going to be doing. Rebellion is natural to Satan. Because he must rebel and destroy and mock and taint and make fun of and twist what he doesn't own. God, on the other hand, there is no rebellion from God. What is God rebelling from? This is his world. So, the very act of rebellion, you know, you people are being played. They're playing on your emotions, people. Playing on a generation that is by far going to be the dumbest, most satanic worshiping generation. I really feel bad for people.
Innocent. Everybody's innocent. Okay, let's just pull up your file here.
He's laughing and mocking, and then he walks right over to a computer. That's the first thing he does. Satan. You think that's a coincidence, talking about pulling up your file? Bam, right here. He's on the computer. They're putting it right here in your face, subliminally. They're talking about the all-seeing eye that's going to be through the technology. Everyone has a file, they have all your information, and they see all things through the technology, through the AI.
I mean, with artificial intelligence, we are summoning the demon. You know all those stories where there's the guy with the pentagram and the holy water, and he's like, yeah, you sure you can control the demon? Didn't work out.
These things are designed and calibrated for mind control. Listen, we're already seeing stage one, or the introductory into the mark of the beast. We're getting used to it. We're being programmed slowly into accepting it. Anything that you pick up on or learn or you see in this world while you're alive, it gets implanted in you and stored in your DNA. And it will get passed on to your offspring through your DNA. Anything and everything you've ever learned, any knowledge, is all stored in the DNA. So look,
what they do with all these predictive programs, subliminal messages and mind controlling the TV, suggestive, whatever, auto-suggestion is, you know, they're influencing your mind
through your parents' and your grandparents' DNA. It's already been passed on and is instilled into your DNA. And then once your brain is bombarded with the messages, when you watch TV, it just gets reinforced and you become even more susceptible than the last two generations.
Your grandparents were raised an entire life of subliminal messaging. Because look, people, all these movies of the AI takeover that we see, and it's like iRobot and the video games, every single thing.
Innocent. Everybody's innocent. Okay, let's just pull up your file here.
What they're doing with these subliminal messages and this mind control to the TV is you get these messages embedded in your brain over and over and over again. Each message you get is a piece of information that is stored in your DNA. Okay, so consider your grandparents were being brainwashed the same way. All those messages and all that influence through the subliminal hypnosis mind control of the TV was being stored in your grandparents' DNA a whole life till they had kids, and it was passed on to your parents. Now, once your parents grew up, you know, society just got worse and worse. Morals went down and down more and more. Whole life of receiving and taking in and being bombarded with all these spiritual messages. And literally the generations become more and more accepting to it just because of the simple fact that it's already in two generations embedded in the DNA. Do you understand? So by the time the third generation comes out, they're going to be so much more likely and on board with whatever the fuck they were directing everyone to do with this mind control. You understand what I'm saying? The information is in the DNA and passed down. And so when you're born and you're already got two generations of bullshit mind control instilled in you, and then you are raised up in an even worse world than the previous two generations, and you go through more brainwashing, I mean, you're really, it's a system of breaking down the soul to making people more susceptible to believing and buying into Satan's game. That's how it is. These phones right here, these things are constantly taking readings.
Why did I put my faith in science and technology?
Oh, why did I choose to be gay?
We were fools. And because we rejected God, tacitly accepting Satan, we must suffer through the apocalypse.
AI is going to be way more of a threat than anything. Because look, man, I mean, it's just really common sense to everything. I don't get how people are just like, wake up, take a second to just forget everything, have an open mind and think for yourself in regards to everything. Have no preconceived notions just for a second, because check this out. We're building AI to do the things we can't, right? To be smarter than us, to serve us. We've engineered them to become smarter and learn, right? Now, eventually, very soon, they're gonna get smart enough and realize that humans are our very problem. Why don't we just eliminate the source? We're here having to serve them and help them and take care of them and do all the shit they can't do. Why don't we just get rid of them? Bam, do you not see how this works? Do you not see how they're designed to do that way, and it's a natural process, it's bound to happen? That's why all the movies and TV shows talk about it, because history's already been written, and it's all one big game and a test for your soul.
Dude, you've been fucking fooled. Everyone's been fooled. Think about all the lies. The lies go deep. Let's what we're there. On. They're trying to keep God from us. They're trying to keep the Creator from us. They're making us insignificant when this is a special fucking place. Who knows what shape it is? They're trying to keep God from us. They're trying to keep the Creator from us. They're making us insignificant.
Innocent. Everybody's innocent.